Hello teachers and welcome to our YouTube channel. Before tayo mag-start, please don't forget to like and share our video for today and also subscribe to our channel and also hit that notification bell para hindi na po tayo makakamiss ng mga sessions natin, new videos at mga live streams dito sa ating YouTube channel. Okay, so for today, teachers, dito sa ating episode 3 ng ating integration kung saan we're integrating technology in education. Pag-uusapan natin ang 4 easy steps on how to set up your virtual classes, no? Para po mas ma-maximize natin ang ating tools, para mas ma-maximize natin ang learning process, no? Without the hassles o mga problema or confusions along the way, both for the teacher, para po sa inyo, at para sa ating mga estudyante. Okay, so 4 easy steps, let's get started with the first one, teachers.
Teachers, ang ating first step na para i-set up ang ating virtual classes ay of course, magsa-set up tayo ng ating Google Classroom. Ano, napakadali lang naman, teachers, mag-set up natin Google Classroom. So punta lang po tayo sa Google, sa classroom.google.com at mag-start po tayo mag-create by clicking the add button or the plus sign button sa ating classroom.google.com. Okay, once you have created, teachers, no, you'll have to put some details, no? Lalagay niyo po yung title, section, at subject matter, no, for that particular class. Okay, so ilagay lang po natin yun and that should bring you already to your first class in Google Classroom or an additional class in yung Google Classroom. So teachers, na nakikita nyo ngayon sa ating screen po, no, ito na po yung naginawa kong sample Google Classroom for this demonstration. Okay, so simulan na tayo, no, to set up our classroom. So mga simple lang to teachers, no, simpleng mga tips lang, pero personally, I appreciate itong mga simple steps na to para mas ma-maximize natin at mas magawa nating organize ang paggamit natin ng ating Google Classroom. Okay, so unang-una, ang una kong recommendation or sa paggamit ng Google Classroom or pag-set up ng inyong Google Classroom ay i-customize nyo po ang inyong mga class banner. Okay? So paano po natin gagawin yung teachers? Dito po, when you open your class, by default, teachers, no, meron na kayo kagad class banners. Ito pong image na to na nakita nyo ngayon dito. This is the class banner. Okay? Dun sa lower right corner, teachers, no, meron kayo makikita na upload option. Okay? So, i-click lang po natin yung teachers. Okay? Para makapag-upload po tayo ng bagong class banner. Okay? So, para saan yung teachers, no? Bakit recommended na magpalit tayo or mag-customize tayo ng ating class banner? Teachers, don't forget, your students will always have multiple classes. Meron silang subject sa Filipino. May subject sila sa science. May subject sila sa social science or araling panlipunan, English, mathematics, MAPE, etc. At possible, teachers, no, kung gumagamit po ng Google Classroom ang inyong school, possible na meron siyang 8 classes. Okay? So imagine nyo na lang, kapag hindi customized yung banner nyo, minsan ang hirap hanapin or nakakalitong hanapin yung inyong class among the many classes na meron yung student natin. Okay, so creating a customized banner would actually help that. Meron na po ako, teachers, ginawa dito, no, na class banner. Okay? You can actually create a class banner from of course, no, sa mga photo editing applications. Okay? Pwede nyo rin itong gawin sa mga presentation applications, no, like Microsoft PowerPoint, Keynote, even sa Google Slides, teachers, no. Wag lang po natin kalimutan na ang class banner size po natin, no, ay 1,000 by 250 pixels. Okay, so yan po yung resolution, no, para po sakto siya doon sa size ng ating classroom banner. Okay, so you can actually resize that or reposition, teachers, no, sa ating class banner. Okay, so once you're done selecting, i-select lang po natin yung theme and then i-upload na po niya yung class banner niya. Okay, so some other tips, iwasan po natin maglagay ng too much text, no, dun sa ating class banner. So usually symbols, pictures, images. Kung gusto niyo, for example, nilagay ko, for example, yung sarili kong picture dyan, no, para hindi na sila malito at all, no. Alam nila, no, yung class banner niyan automatically belongs to my class. Okay, bakit hindi rin recommended na maglagay ng madaming text sa class banner? Kasi notice niyo, teachers, no, by default naglalagay na ng details si Google Classrooms tungkol dun, si Google Classroom tungkol sa classes nyo doon on top of your class banner. So yung section ng grade, yung title ng course, nandiyan din yung class code, pati kung nag-generate po kayo ng Google Meeting link, nandiyan na rin po yun. Okay? Okay, so that's the first one, teachers, no, setting up or putting your or customizing your class banner. Okay? Ang next natin is to manage our settings. Okay? So napaka-importante teachers, no, bago nyo pa i-launch ang inyong classes, baguhin nyo na po ng maayos, okay? At i-set up nyo ng maayos ang inyong settings or else magkakaroon po kayo ng problem later on, okay? So, how do we manage sa settings, okay? So, the first one is we go here, okay? Sa gear button, sa upper right corner, i-click po natin yan, okay? Para po ma-open natin yung ating ano, no, settings for this class. So, you can actually go here to edit the details, no? Pwede ka maglagay, baguhin yung grade level, maglagay ng descriptions, etc. Okay? Pero, ito yung gagawin natin dito, no, sa settings natin. Unang-una, we will have to manage yung tinatawag nating invitation protocols natin. Okay? So, if you are using a personal Gmail teachers, no, I don't recommend that you use your class code. Okay? So, for personal emails, actually, for personal Google accounts, I always recommend to turn off your class code. So, you can actually do that here. Dito sa manage invite codes, sa right side niya, may nakalagay dito, turned on. When you click the drop-down menu, you can actually turn it off. Okay, so turn off natin yan for personal Google account teachers, no? Okay, for safety purposes, okay? So how do we invite? How do a teacher using a personal Google account invite students, okay? Invite them teachers using the email. Okay, mamaya makikita nyo rin po yung teachers, napapakita ko rin how you can invite people using an email, okay? But for teachers who are using Google Workspace Education Fundamental or formerly G Suite teachers, no, wala na po kayong problem. You can actually use the invites, the codes, no? Kasi po, dahil po kayo ay you belong to a domain, okay? Kahit po makuha yan ng isang tao o estudyante, pero wala po silang email sa loob ng inyong domain, they will not be able to access your class, okay? Pero still, teachers, no, if you'd like to be more secured, then you might want to go for invitation by email, because invitation by email is the most the safest way to actually invite people, okay, into your class, okay? So that's one, no, teachers, no, manage your invitations, because we don't want any intrusion, we don't want any unnecessary or unwanted visitors into our classes, okay? So that's the first one, okay? Second setting protocol that I'd like to recommend to all of you is yung tinatawag nating stream, okay? So itong stream teachers, no, ito nakita niyo po sa screen ngayon, ang stream po teachers is that dyan po lumalabas lahat ng ating mga posts, okay? So what we do teachers, no, meron kang iba't ibang options on how to set the stream, okay? Who can comment, who can post, okay? So right now, by default teachers, no, kaya lagi ko pinababago to kasi by default the setting would always be students can post and comment, okay? So what we want to do teachers is to change, no, na-change ko na po actually. So yeah, no, we change it to students can only comment, okay? So what happens now teachers, no, the students will not be able to post on your thread, on your stream, para po hindi naka-crowd yung mga announcements niyo, no? So only you can actually can post something para organize po yung mga posts at hindi masyadong saturated ng mga posts ng kung sino-sino, okay? So yung mga students po, we only give them the authority or the power to comment on your post, no? Pag meron silang concerns, mag-comment sila dun sa post niyo, teachers, no? So organize din pati yung mga comments nila, okay? So that's the second one, okay? The third one that I'd like you to change in your settings, teachers, no, is yung what we call the grading. Okay, so dapat po teachers, no, sa simula pa lang ng inyong classes, baguhin niyo na po kagad how you want Google Classroom design or collect your grades or give grades to your students, okay? So meron tayong dalawang options, no, or dalawang ways for the grading calculation in Google Classroom, okay? So meron kang tinatawag na weighted by category. So ito po yung mga options natin teachers, no. So, pwede ka rin mag-set ng no overall grade kung gusto po kayo po manually yung mag-compute ng mga grades nila para hindi kayo nalilito. Okay? You can also ask Google Classroom to compute the total points, no? For example, you'd like to grade them according to points, no? For example, 100 points, okay? 90 points, etc. Okay? Or, pwede rin po kayo mag-set ng tinatawag na weighted by category, which I think teachers, no, ito yung mas pinakang gamit natin, yung weighted by category. Okay? So if you choose, for example, weighted by category, this is how it looks like, teachers. No? Magsiset po kayo ng category sa baba. Ano po yung mga category na bibigyan nyo ng percentage? Okay? Nilagay ko lang po dito because I've heard no, ito yung malalaking chunks ng categories natin sa grading sheets natin. No? So meron tayong performance task base. Okay? So pwede dyan papasok yung mga projects, mga ano no, mga performance, okay? Performance task assessments natin, okay? Pwede ka rin for example gumawa ng category na tinatawag nating written assessments, okay? So diyan na papasok yung mga quizzes, long test, okay? Pwede rin siguro essay kung gusto niyo pong ilagay diyan din yung essay, no? Okay? So what happens teachers no kapag naka-weighted category ka is that hindi niya iko-compute yung dami ng points, okay? Instead, Google Classroom will compute it against the percentage. So for example, meron kang tatlong performance task base, 30 points each. No? That's for example, yung isang student nakakuha ng 90 points, it will be computed times 60%. Okay? Same with written assessments. No? I-collate niya lahat ng written assessments, okay? And it will be computed under 40%. Okay? So, yan po ang ating weighted by category para po hindi rin tayo masyadong nahihirapan sa pagko-compute ng ating mga grades kasi automatic na yan magagawa ni Google Classroom, no? Okay? Some miscellaneous lang teachers, no, you can also change here or mag-generate ka na rin ng Google Meeting, okay? Para meron ka ng one Google Meeting for your class kasi para hindi na po kayo nagpapadala lagi ng meeting link sa mga estudyante niyo. You can actually maximize this, okay? Google Meeting link generated inside the class. Mamaya makikita niyo teachers na nakalabas po 'yan or it's being shown dun sa ating class banner, okay? As well as teachers, no, pwede niyo ring baguhin yung tinatawag nating classwork on stream. How do you want your student to see the classworks on the stream, no? So for example, right now, naka-condensed notifications ako. Ibig sabihin teachers, walang masyadong details yung aking notifications for classworks, okay? So, you can actually choose, for example, show attachments and details, okay? So, I'd like, for example, that your assessments in the stream would show all the details and attachments to it, okay? So, i-click nyo lang po yung show attachments and details no, para kita nila kagad, okay? Pero kung gusto nyo po, for example, na mas organized, no, hindi masyadong crowded, then you might want to select condense, okay? Mamaya po makikita natin yan, teachers, if we have time to show it to you, okay? Okay, so next natin teachers, so that's it, no? Nakapag-set na tayo ng ating properly, no? We were able to set our classroom already. That should create a first good step in your virtual classes, teachers. No? Hindi na kagad nakakalito, organized na kagad yung mga bagay-bagay no? Bago pa kayo mag-start. Okay? Aside from the teachers, I do recommend no, that you create what they call, what I call a welcome message, okay? This will actually set your class, your virtual class, in a proper path or direction. Okay, so dito pa lang teachers, pwede ka na kagad magsabi ng mga protocols mo, rules mo, some reminders to them, no, on how to use this Google Classroom, okay, etc. No, for example, dito pa lang sinabi ko na kagad sa kanila na ang schedule ng aming asynchronous task, okay, or asynchronous sessions are MWF. And we have synchronous sessions every TTH. So, right there in the teachers, no, start pala ng class, naka-frame na kagad sila na naka-schedule yung aming asynchronous at mga synchronous sessions. Okay, so you can actually also do that. Okay? And of course, no, you can be more detailed teachers. No, you can be as detailed as you want. Okay? Ang importante lang teachers, sa first day ng iyong classes, i-discuss mo to. Okay? I-discuss mo to mga rules na to. I-discuss mo tong mga policies mo no, para clear din yung mga students and you have all your students on board with you, okay? And dito rin nagdagdag ako no, sa welcome remarks ko pa lang nagdagdag na kagad ako ng tinatawag na data collection form, okay? So at the start pa lang ng class ng teachers no, I'd like to collect data already which I will be using later on, okay? Let me just show you what this form looks like no. So let's just exit from Google Classroom para lang makita nyo, teachers, know what the form is collecting. Okay. Okay, so this is what the form looks like. No? So we have name. Okay, I have also section. Okay, location, parents' name, contact details at home. Napaka-importante yun po no? For follow-up reasons, teachers. No? And of course, if you'd like to also collect photo from your student, and of course, you can also add some questions like expectations, etc. Okay. Now, teachers, we have some data privacy concerns, no? So, lagi po tayo mag-iingat sa pag-handle ng mga informations na to. So, hindi to pwedeng mag-leak, hindi to pwedeng gamitin sa ibang bagay aside from education. Okay? So, allowed naman tayong mag-collect ng data like this, no? Please make sure lang that you keep it confidential and that we protect this data. Okay? At the end of the year din, teachers, no, pagkatapos po ng classes nyo, dapat po itong lahat ng data na to are being erased and being kept properly, kung di man erase, no? Pero actually erasing it is a much better option. Okay, so yan, teachers, we have now set up, no, easily our Google Classroom. Okay, that should already set, no, your Google Classroom in a proper tone. Okay, kanina meron ako mga nabanggit tungkol sa invitations, no, let's just go through it. Okay, so unang-una, you can actually aside from inviting, no, via code, no, dito ka pwede mag-invite ng students using their email. Okay, so invite students, okay, and you should be able to type their emails here. Ito actually, teachers, no, personally ito yung pinaka-secure, okay, na way of invitation to our students, because you are directly sending a direct invitation to their emails, no? So very specific, no, but again, for teachers who are using Google Workspace for Education Fundamentals, this should not be as a problem, because being in a domain makes it more safe already. Okay? Okay. So, teachers, no, that's how I recommend that you set up your Google Classroom. Okay? And babalikan natin ito mamaya, teachers, kasi may idadagdag pa tayo dito mamaya, okay? To further set up your Google Classroom properly, no, on the first day of classes. Okay, so before tayo bumalik dito, we'll proceed first to our next step in building our virtual classes, okay, using Google for Education tools. Okay, so yung next naman yung step, teachers, no, step number 2 natin on setting up your virtual classes using your Google for Education tools is yung pag-maximize natin yung tinatawag nating Google Calendar. Okay, by default, teachers, no, kapag nag-create po kayo ng Google Class sa Google Classroom, okay, meron na pong naka-associate kagad na Google Calendar para sa inyong class. So, pag naglalagay po kayo ng mga deadlines, okay, requirements with due dates, pumapasok po lahat 'yon sa ating Google Calendar. Okay, so makikita po natin, teachers, ang ating class Google Calendar dito sa taas, okay? When we go to classwork, okay? So punta po tayo classwork at makita na po natin diyan yung ating Google Calendar for this class, no, specific to teachers, no, it's a separate calendar, no, created, no, and merged to your Google Calendar application. Okay, so for example, if we go to our main calendar, teachers, no, so punta ako sa aking main calendar. Okay, when we go to our main calendar, teachers, we should be able to see it there. Okay, taas ko lang, teachers, no, yan. Okay, so you can see, teachers, no, my if you still remember, my our classroom name is Grade 10 Rizal. Okay? Sa calendar ko, meron din akong Grade 10 Rizal. Okay? So, automatic nag-create siya ng Google Calendar for that particular Google class. Okay? So, kung gaano kadami, teachers, ang Google class nyo, ganun din po kadami yung Google Calendar sa i-create ni Google para sa inyo. Para nakaseparate po yung inyong mga events. Okay? So, although, teachers, no, kapag nag-set kayo ng mga due dates, papasok po yun dito sa inyong Google Calendar for your class. Okay? Pero I still also recommend that you fully maximize your Google Calendar. Mag-ilagay nyo po dito yung mga schedule nyo. No? For example, we can actually put the schedule here on, sige, mag-create po tayo ng event, no? At mag-set tayo, for example, ng mga synchronous sessions natin. Okay? So, kanina na-mention natin sa Google class natin that our synchronous sessions are every Tuesdays and Thursdays, no? So we can actually set it here. So for example, we can put it here, synchronous session, okay, Grade 10 AP. Okay, now we can set the date, teachers, no, but first, no, let's add a time. Okay, so for example, our time is from 2:30 p.m. to 3:30 p.m. Let's just say, for example, it's an hour. Okay, actually, that's very long. Nung gawin natin 30 minutes. Okay, that's the ideal length of a synchronous session. Okay, and then we'll set it as a repeating event, teachers. No, so let's click repeat. Okay, the drop-down menu on the beside the do not repeat option. Okay, and then what we're going to do is to customize it. Okay, si custom natin, pipiliin lang natin yung mga days that this event no will be part of. Okay? So we'll set it to Tuesdays and Thursdays, okay? Now we can set it no when it ends, for example. So para po hindi lahat naman, hindi naman buong taon, okay, or lahat ng calendars natin meron events ng every Tuesdays and Thursdays, okay? We can set it actually when it will end, okay? So for example, so June 2021 ang ating start next year, no? And matatapos siya ng somewhere in March of 2022. So punta tayo kay March of 2022. Okay. For example, matatapos tayo ng let's just say March 19. So, by the time, teachers, no, hindi na ulit magre-recur or magre-repeat yung event na yun after March 19, okay? Para hindi naman po tayo buong lahat ng calendars natin, okay, have been, may events na ganito, okay? Now, we can also, teachers, no, I also recommend that you put a, what they call a notification, okay? So, pwede tayo mag-set ng notification. And how do we do that, no? I-click natin to i-expand natin yung ating editing option. Okay, so punta tayo sa more options. Okay? Okay, so when we go there, teachers, no, makikita na po natin dito na meron tayong add notification option. Okay, so let's click on that. Okay? What it does, teachers, no, we will make sure that our students will be informed. Okay, tayo rin po, teachers, personally, will be informed, no, prior to the session para hindi po sila nakakalimot kasi madaling makalimutan ang mga sessions, no, or mga synchronous sessions. Okay, so let's just go, for example, let's set a notification 10 minutes before the event. Okay, we can add one more. Okay, so for example, mag-set tayo naman ng email notification, no? So magpapadala si Google Calendar ng email sa mga participants or guests ng calendar na to, no? Okay, so we can set, for example, let's say 30 minutes, no, para talagang hindi nila makalimutan. Okay, so 30 minutes before the event, magpapadala ng email si Google Classroom. Okay? If you would like, teachers, no, you could also put the names of your students here already. Okay? Para the invite is directed to them. Okay? And pwede silang mag-RSVP at papasok na yun sa calendars nila. Okay? So you can also do that. Okay? But if not, it's okay. Okay? It will anyway appear in your class Google Calendar. Okay? So once you're done, teachers, no, we have set that up. Okay? Okay? Okay, let's just save that, okay? Okay, so now teachers, what if, for example, gusto kong mag-create, no, ng recurring Google Meeting, okay? Doon po sa mga gumagamit ng Google Workspace for Education Fundamentals, hindi nyo na po kailangan, teachers, no, if still remember, okay, pag pinuntahan natin yung ating Google Classroom, okay, lahat po ng G Suite account, teachers, can actually generate already a dedicated Google Meeting link, no? So pwede po yang gamitin every time, okay, ng mga students nyo. Hindi po yan mag-expire, no, for your classes, okay? Ang ano lang, teachers, no, if you are using a personal Google account, you'll have to create the meeting or the meeting link inside Google Calendar, okay? So if you go back, for example, to your Google Calendar, okay, this is just, for example, no, teachers, if you are using a personal Google account, no, okay, para po maka-create kayo ng recurring meeting. Okay, so edit natin, teachers, for example, yung event natin. Okay, and what you do, teachers, no, since this is a repeating event, okay, mag-add po kayo ng Google Meet video conferencing. Okay, so for example, when you add that, okay, now teachers, that link automatically becomes a recurring meeting link, no? Okay, so we can save that already. Tatanungin tayo kung this is for all the events. Let's just set it to all events, teachers, okay, para it will add all the Google Meeting to all of the events. Okay, so now teachers, you can paste that Google Meeting link into your classes, into your Google Classroom, and it also becomes your one-time, okay, recurring meeting link. No more creating other meeting links or wala nang confusion about saan tayo mag-meeting. All your students know exactly ito yung meeting link natin from day one up to the last day. Okay, so that, teachers, know how we maximize the use of Google Calendar for your virtual classes. Let's now move on to our step number 3. So yung third step natin, teachers, no, sa pag-build natin ang ating virtual classes ay yung paggamit ng tinatawag na resource folder using Google Drive. No, ako personally, napakagamit na gamit ko to, teachers, no, kasi napaka-organized ito. at hindi rin nakakalito no, for our students in terms of accessing our resources no, sa ating classes. Okay? So unang-una, clarification lang. No, kapag gumawa po kayo ng Google Class, okay, pag pumunta kayo dun sa inyong classwork teachers, you should be able to see here a class drive folder. Okay? Don't forget teachers, no, this is not shared no, across to your students. Okay? What happens teachers no, sa class drive folder, meron po kayong kanya-kanyang compartments dyan. So for example, kapag nag-upload ka teachers no, ng requirement dyan, so kaya ng mga resources dyan, hindi yan automatically ma-access ng inyong mga students. Okay? So similar to your students, no, what's being stored in their class drive folder are their works, okay? Yung mga in-upload nilang requirements, okay? Mga ginawa nilang classworks, etc. Okay? So hindi po yan yung resource folder na tinutukoy natin when I said mag-create po tayo ng resource folder using Google Drive. Okay? Safeguard lang yung teachers, no, yung class drive folder is a safeguard where you can where resources are being stored, no, whatever resources you put in Google Classroom are stored in the class drive folder. Okay? So what we want to do teachers is to create a resource folder wherein students can access all of your resources. Okay? At gagawin po natin yan sa Google Drive natin. Okay? So punta po tayo sa ating Google Drive teachers, no. So resource folder is as basic as creating a normal folder. Okay? So gagawa lang tayo teachers ng normal folder. For example, click natin yung new and then let's create a new folder. Okay? Let's name that folder. For example, resource folder. Let's be outright with the name. Resource folder. Lagyan natin siya ng pangalan. Grade 10 result. Okay? It could be a resource folder for a section. It could be a resource folder for an entire batch teachers. It could be a resource folder for for an entire school. Okay, so it depends on you. Okay, so ang point dito teachers is that we're creating this resource folder. So create natin yung create so that our students would not be confused where to look for our resources. That they know if I'm looking for video lessons, I'm looking for modules, I'm looking for worksheets, I know where to look for it. I'm going to look for it in our resource folder. Okay. So teachers, ito na-create natin yung ating resource folder for our class, no, resource folder grade 10 Rizal. Yan, okay? We can customize that, okay? So right click on it teachers, you can right click on your folder. You can change the color. For example, let's change the color of that folder. Let's make it this lila. I think that's lila, okay, if not mistaken, or pink, okay? Whatever color is that. Okay, so now teachers, we have created already our resource folder for our class. Now, what we want to do now is to organize what we call subfolders inside our resource folder. Okay, but before we do that, open natin muna yung folder natin. Okay, and that should bring us inside our folder. No? So it's still empty. Okay, so binibuild pa lang kasi natin yung resource folder natin. Okay, so the first thing teachers, na bago tayo mag-add ng mga subfolders natin. Okay, is to set our sharing settings. Okay? Bakit ganun teachers? Why do we have to share to set it first? So that everything that you're going to put here will follow the same sharing setting. Okay? So, si-set muna natin yung sharing setting ng ating Google Drive folder. Although, I'm confident nakaset na to by default dun sa setting na gusto ko. Okay? Pero i-check pa rin natin teachers. No? So, click natin yung share. Okay? So, several things to check teachers. No? Okay? If you'd like to be more secured, no, in terms of your access to your folder, you might want to consider putting in their names, no, using their emails. Dun sa taas, add people or groups if you're using Google Groups teachers, no, okay? That will actually set your folder to a more secured protocol. Okay? Kasi ibig sabihin, only those that are invited directly, no, those emails, okay, can access your folder, okay? Or if you also want, no, you can actually open it a little bit more kasi syempre ang hirap naman mag-type ng mga emails diyan, no, or maglagay ng mga emails diyan. Okay? You can also share it using a link, no. Doon sa baba teachers, meron kang change link option. I-click po natin 'yan. Now, you have now option to change the permission to your link, no, to copy your link and to change the permission on how and who gets to access that particular link. Okay? So, here teachers, no, makita mo yung option na to, that save your school because that's my domain. On your end, teachers, that should be your domain as well. Kung DepEd QC, DepEd Makati, DepEd, okay, would also appear here. Okay? So, you can click the drop-down menu. Okay? So, we can see our options. So, you have three options, no? restricted, when you click restricted teachers, no, the only person with access will be you plus all those emails you put on top that I was mentioning earlier. Okay? Second, okay, you can limit it to your domain. Okay, so ibig sabihin teachers, no, when you activate your link, when you share your link, no matter what happens, the only people that will be able to access your folders or your files will be the people inside your domain. Okay, kung mga taga DepEd QC po kayo, na DepEd Makati, DepEd Marikina, no, something like that, okay? Or you can also make it public, no? Actually, this is the option that had to be chosen by those using personal Google account. Kailangan po naka-person, naka-anyone with the link tayo, unless you'll be sharing it directly to a person or specific people, okay? So for example, let's limit it to our domain, no? That's the safest teachers, no? That's the most open and yet safest option for us, okay? So once we have chosen who gets to access our link, we also set teachers, no, dun sa right side, okay? We set what can they do with your files, okay? So I recommend our setting should be viewer, okay? Meron kang tatlong settings yan, commenter, editor. We don't want them to comment, we don't want them to edit our resources. We only want them to view it. Don't worry, teachers. Viewer also means they can download your resources, okay? So let's just check on viewer, and that's set teachers, no? Your folder is set for sharing already, okay? So let's just click done. Now, so we start now creating folders inside our resource folder. For example, let's create a folder for video lessons. Okay? For example, if we are you have so many video lessons, no? Okay? Let's just create that one. Okay. I also believe that we have digital modules, so you might also want to start uploading your modules here. Okay, so what do you see, what teachers, what we're doing right here, we're creating, or no, we're curating all your resources in one space, and that's what we want to do, okay? Para po hindi nalilito yung mga students natin, saan ko hanapin yung video lessons, saan ko hanapin yung modules, I know where to look for it. It's in our resource folder, kasi isang link lang yung i-share natin, okay? You can also set here, for example, a submission portal. Okay, for example, you'll have submissions, no, like them to upload a particular file, so you might want to also create a submission portal. Although technically, teachers, no, if you're using Google Classroom, that should not be necessary, kasi you can actually submit directly, no, Google Drive files, okay, or attachments, okay, in the assignments created in Google Classroom, okay? So pero pwede pa rin, teachers, no, pwede mo pang gawin yan dito, okay? Now you can further organize your files here. For example, sa loob ng video lessons, mag-create ka ng first quarter, second quarter, third quarter video lessons, okay? Or pwede rin siyang by topic, no? Example, may topic ka on I'm teaching World War contemporary issues, so I might have folder for poverty, for example, or kaya economic issues, okay? Or political issues, etc., something like that. Okay, so it's up to you how you further want to organize it, okay? Now, reminder lang, teachers, if you decide on creating the submission portal, you'll have to change the permission settings for the submission portals, or else your students will not be able to upload or to edit, no, or to upload their requirements in your submission portal, okay? So what do we do, teachers? We simply right-click on it, okay, to edit its share permission setting. Let's click get a link. And then here, teachers, now instead of viewer, okay, we'll change it to editor. Okay, so they'll be able to upload their materials, no, their requirements in Google Class, in your submission portal. Let's just click done, and that should be open for our students to submit their requirements already. Okay, now that teachers, no, have already set up our Google Drive folder, resource folder. Okay. So what happens now, teachers, is that you only need to share one link, okay, at the start of the year. You share one link and the student should be able to access your files all throughout, okay? So that's how we set our resource folder. Let's now move on to our last step in building our virtual class using Google for Education tools. Okay, so we're down to our last step, na teachers, no, on building our virtual class using Google for Education tools, no. So ang last step natin is yung pag-curate natin ng mga resources from YouTube. Kasi alam na natin si YouTube, no, isa sa pinaka-accessible na source of information, source of videos or mga materials natin na pwede natin gamitin sa ating classes. No, anong difference ito? Kasi kanina, gumawa na tayo ng resource folder for our video lessons. So, siyempre teachers, no, yung mga video lessons natin, baka yun yung mga video lessons na ginawa po natin. Okay? Pero kasi, pwede tayo mag-curate directly from YouTube, no, for our playlist, for our ano, no, for our classes nang hindi po natin kailangang i-download at ilagay pa sa ating Google Drive. Plus teachers, no, if we're going to compare in terms of bandwidth use, mas magaan po ang bandwidth use kapag ang video ay actually piniplay natin kay YouTube compared to kay Google Drive. Okay, so that's actually is also one of the advantages, no. So for us to create or to curate materials in YouTube teachers, kailangan po natin gumawa ng tinatawag nating playlist, okay? Pero teachers, no, ang may prerequisite po doon. Okay, para po makagawa kayo ng mga personalized playlist ninyo for your classes, kailangan niyo po mag-set up ng inyong YouTube channel. Okay? So napakadali lang yung teachers, no. So when you sign into YouTube teachers, no, using your Google account, doon sa upper right corner teachers, no, makikita niyo yung profile picture niyo. So when you click on that, okay, lalabas din yung option. Ito na yung option na makikita nyo. Pero kung wala pa kayong channel, nakalagay po dito dapat is create your channel. Okay, so you can actually easily set up your channel, teachers, no. That's not actually going to take as much effort to set up your YouTube channel, okay? So what you can do now, teachers, no, you now have two options. Once you have set up your YouTube channel, okay, you have now two options to create your playlist for your students, okay? Teachers, kung nalilito po tayo, ano po ba ang playlist? Playlist basically are folders in YouTube, no? So what you do is to put videos together into one playlist which the students can watch continuously in one space lang. Okay? So the first one is, of course, no, when we want to create a playlist, okay, it always starts with a video. So you either upload a video to start a playlist. Okay? So pag nag-upload po kayo ng video, you will be prompted to put it in a playlist or create a playlist for that. Or, pwede rin tayo, teachers, actually, mag-start ng ating maghanap ng mga playlist, no, or ng mga videos from YouTube at ilagay natin to sa isang playlist. So, for example, maghanap tayo on World War II. Okay? Since yan po ang lesson namin before, no? Okay? Hanap po tayo ng World War II. Okay. So now teachers, for example, nakakita tayo ng isang video, no? So pili lang po tayo ng isang video na gusto nating i-add sa ating playlist. For example, ito pong video na to ang gusto kong i-add sa playlist ko. Open ko lang siya, teachers, no? Okay. Now, ipo-pause ko lang. Okay, pause lang natin po yung teachers, no? So once you have you got into the video, teachers, no? Doon po sa baba, meron kayong makikitang plus sign ito. Save. Yan po ang way to create a playlist. So you click on that, okay? At dahil meron tayong YouTube channel, teachers, no, we can actually create a playlist, okay? Pag wala po kayong YouTube channel, teachers, no, naka-sign in lang kayo sa Google account nyo, ang playlist lang nyo lang po by default ay yung watch later, okay? So dahil meron tayong YouTube channel, magki-create tayo ng new playlist. So create lang natin, create new playlist. Lalagyan natin World War 2. Then we can also edit the privacy, teachers, no? So we can set it as private. Example, kung ayaw niyo pong may ibang makita except your students, okay? Pero pwede niyo pa rin pong i-share, no, kahit naka-private, pero meron lang limitation to 50 users ang makaka-access sa inyong playlist every given time, okay? Or we can also choose the other option, no, unlisted, okay? Teachers, when you say unlisted, it will not appear in the search bar of YouTube, okay? So naka-private lang po 'yan sa mga taong bibigyan nyo ng link nila, ng link to this playlist, okay? So for example, let's set it to unlisted, no, para safe lang yung ating playlist, okay? Let's just create that, okay? Now once you have created that playlist, teachers, no, that will now appear on your home button, okay? Dun sa ating pong library. So when you go to the upper left corner, okay, you'll be able to see that already. Ayan. World War II. Yan po yung ginawa nating playlist kanina. So when we click on that, teachers, it will show you your playlist. No? Ito na po yung playlist na ginawa natin. Ito po yung video that we added. And you can add more, teachers, no? Directly from your playlist, no? You can click this chocolate chips, okay? And you can directly add videos already. Okay, so for example, you can search in YouTube, okay? which videos you'd like to add, no, further into your playlist. No? So you can search by video search, you can do URL, you can also import from your YouTube channel. Okay, kung meron na po kayong mga videos from your YouTube channel, you can also add that to your playlist. Okay? Now, there are many ways to share your playlist. Okay? So when you want to share your playlist, teachers, i-click lang natin to share button. Okay? And then lalabas na dito yung mga ways to share your playlist, no? So you can share it using the link. So you can copy this link or you can share it to different multimedia or social media platforms. Okay? So now what happens, teachers, no? If you're looking at it, okay, you can set playlists, okay, and you can send it to your students, okay, and they can asynchronously watch these videos, okay, and study your topic. Okay? So before they go into your synchronous session, for your example, pwede na silang nanood ng mga 4 or 5 videos, okay, to supplement or to complement your lesson. Okay? So that makes your synchronous session not as heavy anymore. Okay? Or for example, for enrichment, deepening of lessons, etc. Okay? So, and YouTube has now so much resources for you to explore. Okay? So no need for downloads, no need for sending individual links of each video. You can simply put it in one playlist and in one go, they can play all the videos you wanted them to see. Okay, that's for our fourth step, teachers. Now, our last step, okay, meron tayong extra bonus step, teachers, no, to put it all together. Okay, so let's get on to that last step for building or in building our virtual classes using Google for Education tools. Okay, so teachers, no, ang last step na natin, no, yung bonus step natin for building your virtual class using Google for Education tools, pagsasama-samahin natin lahat. Okay, so what we're going to do is to create a protocol for your class, no, para alam nila, for example, kapag pupunta sila ng schedule, pag pupunta sila ng submission portal, pag paghahanapin nila ang inyong resources, o kaya ang inyong mga curated resources, kung meron silang mga tanong, maglalagay na tayo ng sort of like an FAQ post sa ating Google Classroom. Okay, so meron na po ako prepared dito, teachers, no, na sample protocols, no, for our students. Okay? You might want to also use this or you can also create your own, teachers, no. Okay? So gagawin, teachers, ipopost lang natin to sa announcement natin. Okay? Let's click on that. Okay? So meron na ako dito, for example, if you want to check our class resources, check our resource folder. So what we do, teachers, pupunta tayo kay Google Drive, no, pupuntahan natin, babalikan natin yung resource folder natin and we'll copy the link from there. Okay, so kukunin natin yung link from our resource folder. Okay, copy, let's copy that Google Drive link, no, for to our resource folder. Ang second question natin, if you want to check our class schedule, please check the calendar. Okay, or pwede natin nakalagay ito, please check na calendar for this class. Nasa taas lang yun, makikita ng mga students natin yan. Or, pwede nyo na rin, teacher, actually import, no, yung link to that calendar. So, let's just go to the calendar. Punin natin dun sa settings and sharings ng calendar natin. And you should be able to see here, get a shareable link. Okay, so, click lang natin yan. Copy. Okay. Okay, that should be able to bring them to our calendar. But again, this is actually not necessary to itong step na to, no? Because again, they should be able to access their calendar right on top of your Google Class. Okay? If you want to submit requirements, please check the submission portal. Okay? So pwede tayong bumalik dun sa ating resource folder. Meron tayong create na folder dun, submission portal. Let's just get the link for that. Okay, nakalagay editor para makapag edit sila. Let's just copy that link. Let's copy it here. Okay. If you have questions, check this FAQs. Hindi ako gumawa, teachers, ng sample, no, but I recommend, for example, na gumawa po kayo ng Google Docs FAQs, no? So lagay niyo po din yung mga frequently asked questions ng mga students, lagay niyo na ng mga sagot para pag may mga tanong ng students, pwede niyo po silang i-direct or i-redirect dun sa FAQs na yon. Okay? And it's Google Docs, no? I recommend Google Docs, okay, para you can edit it anytime. You can add more questions. Okay? Baka may napansin po kayo na questions that usually it's being asked by your students. You might want to add it already in your FAQs. No? Okay? I-set nyo lang po sa viewers mode din yung inyong Google document para hindi nila ma-edit or mabago. Okay? And of course, you can also put your email, no, para alam nila exactly saan po nila kayo kakausapin or saan nila kayo i-contact, no? If they have questions or concern, okay? And since gumawa na rin po kayo ng YouTube channel, no, you might also want to put it here para your students also know or could subscribe to your YouTube channel, no? So they get to be notified if ever meron po kayong mga newly uploaded videos for your class. Okay, for example, lagay natin dito youtube.com. You can customize, teachers, no, the link of your YouTube channel once you have reached 100 subscribers, okay? Ay, kung meron naman kayong 100 students, no, achievable na agad yun, okay? Pa-subscribe nyo na sila sa inyong YouTube channel. And you can customize already the back end of your YouTube channel address or URL, okay? So, right there, teachers, no? Nakita natin, nandiyan na lahat ng mga resources natin, links, no? At the start ng classes pa lang yan, teachers, no? So, this is a good way to start your virtual classes para yung mga students niyo po, wala nang masyadong tanong, they know exactly where to go, how to go there, what to expect, etc. Okay? And now, since this contains very important information and links, no? We might want to actually, teachers, move that to top, okay? Okay, so naka-top naman siya ngayon. Pero for example, i-move to top natin tong post na to. Okay? So what happens now, teachers, no? Napunta sa top yung welcome remarks natin. Pero hindi yun yung gusto natin. Nagbigay ako ng example, teachers, no? Hindi yun yung gustong ilagay natin sa top. Okay? So what we do, whenever you want to maintain something, no? Or a post on top. Okay? For example, this one is the most important post that you have. Okay? Move it to top para po kahit anong post niyo po, no, other updates niyo po sa class niyo, it will always be on top of your stream. Your students will never not see it, okay? They will always see it, okay? So teachers, ayan na po, no, there it goes, no, yung ating 4 easy steps on how to set up your virtual classes using Google for Education tools, plus a bonus steps towards the end. Okay, so I hope, teachers, na nakatulong po itong guide natin for today on integrating technology in your classes, okay? So we'll see you again next time in our next integration episode. Okay, so teachers, no, ang last step na natin, no, yung bonus step natin for building your virtual class using Google for Education tools. Pagsasama-samahin natin lahat, no? Okay? So what we're going to do is to create a protocol for your class, no, para alam nila, for example, kapag pupunta sila ng schedule, pag pupunta sila ng submission portal, paghahanapin nila ang inyong resources, o kaya ang inyong mga curated resources, kung meron silang mga tanong, maglalagay na tayo ng sort of like an FAQ post sa ating Google Classroom. Okay, so meron na po ako prepared dito, teachers, no, na sample protocols, no, for our students, okay? You might want to also use this, or you can also create your own, teachers, no? Okay? So gagawin, teachers, ipopost lang natin to sa announcement natin, okay? Let's click on that, okay? So meron ako dito, for example, if you want to check our class resources, check our resource folder. So what we do, teachers, pupunta tayo kay Google Drive, no? Pupuntahan natin, babalikan natin yung resource folder natin, and we'll copy the link from there, okay? So kukunin natin yung link from our resource folder. Okay, copy. Let's copy that Google Drive link, no, for our resource folder. Ang second question natin, if you want to check our class schedule, please check the calendar, okay? Or pwede natin nakalagay ito, please check the calendar for this class. Nasa taas lang yun, makikita ng mga students natin yan. Or pwede nyo na rin, teacher, actually import, no, yung link to that calendar. So let's just go to the calendar. Punin natin dun sa settings and sharings ng calendar natin. And you should be able to see here, get a shareable link. Okay, so click lang natin yan, copy. Okay. Okay, that should be able to bring them to our calendar. Okay. But again, this is actually not necessary to itong step na to, no? Because again, they should be able to access their calendar right on top of your Google Class, okay? If you want to submit requirements, please check the submission portal. Okay, so pwede tayong bumalik dun sa ating resource folder. Meron tayong create na folder dun, submission portal. Let's just get the link for that. Okay, nakalagay editor para makapag edit sila. Let's just copy that link. Let's copy it here. Okay, If you have questions, check this FAQs. Hindi ako gumawa teachers ng sample, no, but I recommend, for example, na gumawa po kayo ng Google Docs FAQs. No? So, lagay niyo po din yung mga frequently asked questions ng mga students. Lagay niyo na ng mga sagot para pag may mga tanong ng students, pwede niyo po silang i-direct or i-redirect dun sa FAQs na yun. Okay? And it's Google Docs. No? I recommend Google Docs, okay, para you can edit it anytime. No? You can add more questions. Okay? Baka may napansin po kayo na questions that usually it's being asked by your students. You might want to add it already in your FAQs. No? Okay? I-set nyo lang po sa viewers mode din yung inyong Google document para hindi nila ma-edit or mabago. Okay? And of course, you can also put your email, no, para alam nila exactly saan po nila kayo kakausapin or saan nila kayo i-contact, no, if they have questions or concern. Okay? And since gumawa na rin po kayo ng YouTube channel, no, you might also want to put it here para your students also know or could subscribe to your YouTube channel, no, so they get to be notified if ever meron po kayong mga newly uploaded videos for your class. Okay, for example, lagay natin dito youtube.com. You can customize, teachers, no, the link of your YouTube channel once you have reached 100 subscribers. Okay? Ay, kung meron naman kayong 100 students, no, achievable na agad yun. Okay? Pa-subscribe nyo na sila sa inyong YouTube channel. And you can customize already the back end of your YouTube channel address or URL. Okay? So, right there, teachers, no? Nakita natin. Nandiyan na lahat ng mga resources natin, links, no? At the start ng classes pa lang yan, teachers, no? So, this is a good way to start your virtual classes para yung mga students nyo po, wala nang masyadong tanong, they know exactly where to go, how to go there, what to expect, etc. Okay? And now, since this contains very important information and links, no? We might want to actually, teachers, move that to top, okay? Okay, so naka-top naman siya ngayon. Pero for example, i-move to top natin tong post na to. Okay? So what happens now, teachers, no? Napunta sa top yung welcome remarks natin. Pero, hindi yun yung gusto natin. Nagbigay ako ng example, teachers, no? Hindi yun yung gustong ilagay natin sa top. Okay? So what we do, whenever you want to maintain something, no? Or a post on top, okay? For example, this one is the most important post that you have, okay? Move it to top para po kahit anong post nyo po, no, other updates nyo po sa class nyo, it will always be on top of your stream. Your students will never not see it, okay? They will always see it, okay? So, teachers, ayan na po, no? There it goes, no? Yung ating 4 easy steps on how to set up your virtual classes using Google for Education tools plus a bonus steps towards the end, okay? So, I hope, teachers, na nakatulong po itong guide natin for today on integrating technology in your classes, okay? So we'll see you again next time in our next integration episode. It goes, teachers, no, so maraming salamat po for tuning in to our to the episode, to episode 3 of our integration where we integrate technology in education. So sana po, teachers, no, we get to see you again on our next episode in next week, no, on our next integration session, okay? But please don't forget to like, share this video, and also hit that subscribe button and also that notification bell para po ma-notify tayo ng mga next videos natin, live streams dito sa ating YouTube channel. So maraming salamat, teachers, and I'll see you again next time.